Good morning, everyone. Once again, in the lecture of cyber security and digital forensic. Till now, we had discussed the various concepts regarding the cyber security. Under this, we had discussed earlier in the previous topic that what do you mean by the threats and what are the types of cyber attacks? How that attacks will cause the particular organizations, how the impact of that particular cyber attack and all the things. So whenever we are going to discuss about the topic related with the cyber attacks and cyber security, one of the concept will be keep in mind that the criminal minded persons may use the different kind of technology, tools and methods for for attacking the particular organizations, or attacking on the organizations to steal their particular data, to capture their particular information from the confidential information from the given server. So they are going to use the different techniques, methods to do such kind of a vulnerable kind of activity. So one of the topic related with the same, that is the malicious code. That malicious code is the term that will be used in the cyber security or cyber crime, that it will be describe any code in any part of the software system or the script. Means you are going to insert, you are going to add some code in the software system also, or in a particular scripting also. So that is intended to cause undesired effects, security breaches or damage to a particular systems. So whenever the criminal minded person injected some kind of a code, malicious code into the software system, so that may cause or damage the particular system, so that you are unable to working with your own system with a proper authentication, and you are not getting the retrieving the data from the computer system. So that code we call it the malicious kind of a code. Malicious code is an application security threat that cannot be efficiently controlled by conventional antivirus and software alone. So to handle such kind of a malicious code, we need a proper protection to the organizations or to the networks, to the particular system, so that that code not get entered into the particular system and your system may not get damaged. So these are the some thing we can say that related with the malicious code. As malicious code is a one of the type of attack also, and it will increases the execution of viruses, worms, Trojan horses and web scripting into the particular information into the hacker by used by the particular hacking the websites and all the things. So that these attacking system will be started from the 2002, and that will be uses the concept of worm and all the things to attack on the system. So as considering the malicious code, that is IP scan attack, web browsing viruses, shares, mass mails, and all the things have the attack replication vector will be available with the malicious code. So as considering the types of a malicious code, that there under we had going to discuss about what is mean by the viruses. As you know that viruses is nothing but a malicious software program. When it is executed, it replicates itself by modifying other computer programs and inserted its own code. So whenever the viruses will be created or designed or developed by the particular programmer, that time programmer means viruses also designed by the particular programmer to deactivate the particular system. So whenever these viruses will be design and develop at that time, that code may be able to destroy your system. If that viruses will be entered into your system by using the weaknesses of your particular system, so that viruses may get replicate itself in your particular system and modify all the information, or it may try to insert their own code in each and every activity of the particular system. So that may damage your system, that may damage your particular data, it may happen that your data may get corrupted also because the viruses will be entered into the system. So these are, to avoid such kind of viruses, then we are again design the antiviruses or antidotes, bol sakte hain usko, that will be designed for the to avoiding such kind of activity. Means that you know that net protector and quick heal and Norton and all the things, all the antiviruses have designed their particular programming, particular application, so that they will try to provide some kind of a protection to your system by using the antiviruses. So viruses may infected machine and may infect certain common executable or script data on the particular computer to which it can write with the virus code, and that can cause the particular infections. Once the viruses will be get entered, so it may get infected all the data, it may get we can say that it damage the particular scripting of the particular data also. These are some concepts regarding with the viruses. As you know that in the viruses also, so viruses have the different kind of categories that may contain direct actions, that may have the browser hijackers, overwrite viruses, web scripting viruses, file infector, network viruses, boot sector viruses. These are some common types which will be associated with the computer viruses, that multi-parties the viruses that will infected the entire system and that spread by performing unauthorized action to the operating system. As considering the term that is the types of malicious code, that is the worm. Worm is a standalone malware which replicate itself in order to spread to other computers. So malware is nothing but the malicious code that will be uses, and worms comes under the one of the malicious code of a crime. Computer worm is a type of malware that spread copies of itself from computer to the computer. So it may happen that if the worm will be get entered into your particular system, that time it may get copied itself from computer to computer in the network, so that your system may get damaged, and worm can be replicated itself without any human interaction also, and it does not need to attach itself to a software program in order to cause the damage. So they may get replicated itself, they may get copied itself into the particular system. Worms can be also get transmitted via software vulnerabilities also, or a computer worm could arrive as an attachment in a spam emails or instant messages also. So it may happen that worms may get attached to the particular spam message which will be occurred in the particular email box and all things, and instant messages also. Once you are going to open that particular worms file, these files could be provided a link to malicious websites or automatically download the computer worms. So you know that whenever you are going to open some kind of websites, different kind of websites, at that time it may happen that some linking files or click on this site, you will get the particular offers. ऐसे आपके पास में कुछ कभी कभी blink होते रहता है, तो ऐसे बहुत सारे advertisement भी आपके यहाँ पर आती है. तो if you are going to click on such kind of advertisement or activity or link on the particular website, so you may get converted to the malicious website or your system may get downloaded automatically, the different kind of worms. And once this worms if installed, the worm silently goes to the work and infect the machine without the user's knowledge. So ये भी हो सकता है कि ऐसे कुछ एक्टिविटी करने से योर सिस्टम में गेट डाउनलोडेड मल्टीपल वर्म्स एंड योर सिस्टम में गेट कैन सी दैट की गेट इन्फेक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ द वर्म्स. वर्म्स कैन मॉडिफाई एंड डिलीट द फाइल्स ऑल्सो एंड दे कैन इवन इंजेक्टेड एडिशनल मेलेशियस सॉफ्टवेयर ऑन टू द पर्टिकुलर कंप्यूटर्स. सो इफ़ कंप्यूटर वर्म्स पर्पज इज जस्ट ओनली टू मेक द कॉपीज ऑफ इट सेल्फ ओवर द ओवर एंड ओवर. So in a different system of a network, in a computer system, that worms get copied itself and depleting the particular system resources, such as the hard drive, the bandwidth of the internet, and overloading of the shared networks. So these are some reasons, effect which will be occurred when the worms get inserted into the particular system. Worms can also steal the data, install a backdoor also, and allow hacker to gain control over the particular computer system also and system setting also. So because that network worms is a very difficult to handle, to avoid such kind of computer worms and to getting help to protect your system from the computer worms, you need to protect your you need to provide proper solutions for the system also. To protect from the worm, you need to provide that the all the system that you are going to use, all the operating system that you are going to use for your system, that an application also may be up to date and latest version you need to be get installed into your particular system. So this is about the term worms. Then another type of a malicious code, that is a Trojan horses, or I think all of you may get hear the term Trojan horses in your graduation level also. So Trojan horses is nothing but a program that claims to free your computer from viruses, but instead introduces viruses onto your particular system. So if the Trojan horse and all the things will be get entered in your system, so it may happen that or it may difficult to get relief from the such activity. So what is a Trojan horse, we are going to discuss about it. Trojan horse or the Trojan that will be get if entered into the particular system, that Trojan may get control of your all the computers, and that Trojan will be designed to damage, to disrupt, steal, or general inflict some other harmful action on your particular data or the networks. So I think all of you may get aware about the Trojan horses, that if that Trojan horse attack on your particular system, it is one of the type of malicious code, and that system get infected from the Trojan horses, and that may damage your system. Trojan acts like a bona fide application or a file to trick you, means it will deceive you into the loading and executing the malware on your particular devices. Once that Trojan horse get installed, a Trojan can perform their action in it was designed for, means for what purpose that Trojan will be designed that may get developed and activated. Trojan is sometimes we are going to call Trojan viruses, Trojan horse viruses. There are the various names associated with that particular Trojan. Viruses can execute and replicate themselves, Trojan can't. A user has to execute Trojans. Even so, Trojan malware and Trojan viruses are often used interchangeably. So how the Trojan will be working and all the things that will be the not we are going to discuss about it. So common type of Trojan viruses or Trojan malware will be available. It is a backdoor Trojan, then the distributed denial of services attack Trojan, downloaded Trojan, Fig AV Trojan, GameThip Trojan, and many more that will be associated with the particular Trojan viruses. So Trojan may be get impact on mobile devices also. So Trojans are possible for only laptop and desktop computer. They can also impact your mobile devices, including the cell phone and the particular tablets. So Trojan will be come attached to the what look like a legitimate kind of a programs, and it may provide you the fake version of the applications loaded up with the particular malware. So cyber criminal try to usually place them on a unofficial and pirated applications market for the user to download it. Means these Trojan viruses may provide impact on your particular mobile devices also. So these applications can also steal information from your devices, that the Trojan activated application that will be available on the particular pirated application will be available on the market, that may infected your particular devices also. They get steal your information from your devices and generate revenue by sending the premium SMS kind of a text. So if such kind of activity will be affected with your particular devices, so you can think about the Trojan viruses. For the Android devices specifically, they are going to design the Trojan malware called a Switcher Trojan for the Android mobile Android devices. Switcher Trojan is a design. It infects user devices to attack the router on their wireless networks. So cyber criminal could redirect traffic on the Wi-Fi connected devices and use it to commit viruses crimes, various kind of a crimes. So these are some concept with the particular Trojan viruses. Then we are going to move towards the botnet. Botnet used to perform distributed denial of service attack, that is a DDoS attack, steal data, send spam, and allow the attacker access to the devices and its connections. So botnet is a bot is a piece of a malware that infects a computer to carry out commands under the remote control of the attackers. Means keep in mind that bot is a piece of a malware that infects a computer to carry out commands under the remote control of the particular attacker. So botnet, or short for the robot networks, means that botnet will be terms comes under the in a particular using, that is a, it will be short form for the robot network. Is a network or a computer infected by the malware that are under the control of single attacking party known as the bot header. So once the bot will be created, or if you are going to control by the particular attacker, so some actions will be considered with the particular botnet. Botnet attack is a type of cyber attack that will be carried out by the group of internet connected devices controlled by the malicious attackers, so that your devices get damages. So as considering the botnet, so some infected activity will be considered under the botnet, that is email spamming. So through the email is they are going to send spam messages, and once you are going to open or click on that particular link in the spam messages, you are get activated. Then DDoS attack, then financial breach, targeted institution, these are some kind of type will be affiliated with the botnet. So once we are going to getting the time in the upcoming lecture also, we are going to discuss about more about the concept of a botnet. Then we are moving toward the keylogger. It is one of the type of malicious code that is a type of a surveillance technology used to monitor and record each keystroke type on a specific computer's keyboard. So hackers may have the capacity that key, if you are going to use your particular system, which key or which keys you are going to use, you are going to type on a computer keyboard, that also get monitored by them also. As you know that key, I think recently news, yesterday or day before yesterday news, that the one of the hacker from the Pakistan are sending the mails to the particular internet users. I think I don't know exactly naam, kuch naam bhi unhone display kiya tha kal ek news channel mein. Agar is naam se aapko mail aata hai, to don't open this kind of a mail. So these are the some kind of a it is a real time monitoring, means we can see that keylogger is nothing but it is a real time monitoring by the particular hackers. So what kind of activity you are going to do with the particular system, which keys you are going to press, that all get monitored by the particular attackers, and that may get monitored each and every activity by your particular key. So attackers may try to design, may try to do the programming regarding the particular attacking of the technology. As considering the keylogger also we call it as is one of the oldest form of a cyber threat also, and keystroke logger record the information also what you are going to type into website or the application and send to back to the particular third party. So what are going to answer attacking attackers may try to monitor what kind of activity you are going to type in the particular keyboard. So by using that key logger, attackers or criminal minded person, by using the key loggers, they are going to steal personal or the financial information such as banking details, which they can sell to the another organization for their particular profit. I think in the most of the shayad aapne movies mein bhi dekha hoga ki kabhi kabhi jahan pe aise door lock system hote hain ya phir aise kuch वो यूज़ करते हैं डिवाइसेस, डैट कि कुछ नंबर प्रेस करने के बाद वहाँ पे आपके फिंगर्स के कुछ जो बोलते हैं आप कि कौन से बस बटन को आपने प्रेस किया मल्टीपल टाइम्स, दैट में गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू द अनदर टाइप. सो उस पर से भी वो लोग पता चल पाते हैं कि कौन से बटन आप प्रेस करते हो, और इस पर्टिकुलर जो है कॉन्फिडेंशियल रूम का पर्टिकुलर पासवर्ड क्या होता है वो दे कैन डिफेक्टेड. ऐसे ही बहुत सारे टेक्निक्स अवेलेबल है. सो की लॉगर इज अ टाइप ऑफ अ स्पाईवेयर दैट कैन बी यूज टू ट्रैक एंड लॉक द कीज यू स्ट्राइक ऑन योर पर्टिकुलर कीबोर्ड. सो दिस इज अबाउट द की लॉगर. देन वी आर मूविंग टूवर्ड द रूट किट, दैट इज वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ अ मालवेयर कोड, मेलिशियस कोड, दैट इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ टूल्स और प्रोग्राम्स दैट एनेबल administrator level access to the computer or a computer networks. So name itself suggests that it will be enables hackers to install additional kind of a malicious software that steal sensitive information like credit card numbers and social security information by accessing as a administrator kind of a power to the particular hackers. So it is originally a rootkit was collection of tools that enabled administrative access to the particular computer networks. So rootkit are associated with the particular malicious type of a software that provides root level privileges accesses. That is a root level means that will be provided the higher level of accessing privilege accesses to the particular computer while hiding its existence and the actions. Hacker uses rootkits to conceal themselves until they are going to decide to execute their particular malicious malware. So these are means rootkit, if you are going to get activated in your particular system or network, so that hackers will getting the privileges that key, that is up to the higher level, up to the root level. So administrator level kind of actions or the privilege will be getting them, so he can may consider ki damage your particular system. Rootkits can be deactivated anti-malware and antivirus software also, and badly damaged user mode applications. So attackers can also use rootkit to spy on your user behavior, launch DDoS attacks, and getting some privileges and steal sensitive information or the data from the system. So maybe if the rootkit will be get attacked on your particular system, so they are going to stolen your sensitive data. They again malware get infected into system, file will be removing from the particular system, and remote access we are going to see that will be get accessed by the particular attackers. As considering the types of rootkits attacks, the application rootkits is one of the type, then kernel rootkits, then the bootloader rootkits, hardware and firmware rootkits, and virtualized rootkits. These are the some types come under the rootkits. To prevent from the such kind of rootkit on a daily basis, because rootkits are the dangerous and the harmful, they get only infect your computer if you are launched the malicious software that carries the particular rootkit. Means after launching such kind of malicious software, that then only then the rootkit will get activated. So scan your system many times. Scanning system is the best protection for the to avoiding the rootkits. Update your software on the monthly or daily basis so that you get particular protection. Use next generation kind of antiviruses and many more. So these are some topic we can say that about the rootkit. Then we are moving toward the another topic of the malicious code, that is the spyware. Spyware concept that will be just used in a previous, that is the keylogger is one of the type of spyware also. Spyware is any software that install itself on your computer and start covertly monitoring your online behavior without your knowledge or the permission. Means जैसे कि की लॉगर में इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू यूज द की लॉगर, दैट की लॉगर विल मॉनिटरिंग ऑल द एक्टिविटी, रियल टाइम एक्टिविटी ऑफ द की प्रेकिंग प्रेसिंग ऑफ द यूज़र. तो स्पाइवेयर ऑल्सो इज मॉनिटरिंग ऑल द बिहेवियर ऑफ द इंटरनेट यूज़र विदाउट योर परमिशंस. तो स्पाइवेयर इज काइंड ऑफ अ मालवेयर दैट secretly gather information about the person or the organizations also and release this data to the other parties. So what kind of action, what kind of behavior of the user on the internet that may be captured by the particular criminal minded person, then each and every action that you are going to use on the internet that may get considered on the get captured by the internet user, so that they capture or they gather all the information, and that information will be get sale to the another party also. So spyware is a software with malicious behavior that aim to gather the information about the person or the organization. So as considering the spyware, there are some four symptoms you can discussing that key what the common symptoms regarding with the spyware. Difficulty to logging into secured website like Icon and My UI, that time these are the symptoms about the spyware. Random advertisement that pop up on your particular computer, so that is the symptoms of the spyware. Unusual slowness of your system, that is the symptoms of the spyware. Unusual instability in your system means your computer may get crashes more and more time. So that is the common symptoms of the spyware. So once you are get infected from the particular spyware, so your behavior on the internet may get captured or information may get gathered from the particular attackers. About 80% of all the internet users have their system affected by the spyware. About 93% of spyware components are present in each of the computers also, and 89% of the computer users were unaware about their particular existence. So aapke computers mein spyware hai, they are going to watching you don't know. Lagbhag 80% users ke system affected by the particular spyware, and they don't know exactly the spyware will be watching them. So ye sabke system mein maybe rehta hai. These are the some concepts related with the spyware. Then we are going to move toward the another topic of a malicious code, that is a adware. As you know, that name itself suggests that it designed to display advertisement on your computer and redirect your search request to the advertising website to collect the marketing data about you. So whenever you are going to use the different kind of a website purposely for your particular work, at that time some advertisement may get flashes on your particular website. If you are going to click on the particular website, if you are going to you can say that get directed to the particular website, so your particular data or search request will be get redirected from the to the particular advertisement, and that advertisement website may collect your all data so that that data may be get sell to the marketers also. These are the some concept about the adware. Also known as the advertisement supported software generated for the revenue for its developer, and it automatically generating some kind of a advertisement continuously on your particular screen. So aap jab bhi kabhi dekhte ho, that will be you can say that automatically jab dekhte ho advertisement, that is the adware. Adware is typically created for a computer but can also be founded on mobile devices also. So jo particular adware advertisement that will be designed specifically for the computer person, but recently that also be available on the mobile devices also. So all the advertisement will be get manipulated properly, so and that will display unwanted or pop-up adverts which can appear on your particular computers or mobile devices, and that will may get redirected to the particular another websites. To avoid, or I think you may know that the adware works, how it adware will be work, you know the concept of the PPC, pay per click, pay per view and pay per install, barabar hai. So these are the come under the particular adware. So whenever you are going to means these are the properly designed advertisement will be available on your particular website, and if you are going to click on that particular advertisement, so the programmer or developer will get some kind of remuneration for clicking on each time. I mean, how many times you are going to click on that particular website, up to that level that developer will be get some kind of amount. So pay per click, that is that they get paid each time you open an particular advertisement. Pay per view, that is PPV, they get paid each time an ad is shown on to the particular users. Pay per install, that is they get paid each time bundle software is installed on the particular devices. So because of that, some programmers or developers try to design some kind of adwares so that key users will be get converted to the particular advertisement, and they will be getting some kind of a revenue from the adware.
Then we are moving toward the another topic of the malicious code, that is the ransomware. I think in 2016 that ransomware will attack on the most of the organizations' systems, and they haven't provided the permissions, you can say that, or they haven't provided the authentication to open the data from the system. So ransomware is a malware that prevents or limits user from accessing their system, either by locking the system screen or by locking the user's files, unless a ransom is paid. Means if ransom viruses will be attacking on your particular system, so they are going to block you. They are not going to provide the authentication to your own system also to access the particular data from the system. So either may they get locked your particular system screen, so that key, if you want to open that system, the ransomware will be needed some kind of a remuneration, or you need to pay some amount to provide or accessing the particular system of yours regarding the ransomware. That ransomware in 2017 that will be get attacking on the most of the organizations, and that organizations have paying much more amount to open their own data. Ransomware is a type of malware from cryptovirology that threatens to publish the victim's personal data or personally block access to the particular system. Usually all the ransomware make it is a malicious software malware that threatens to publish or block the access of the data of the system, usually by encrypting it until the victim pay ransom fee to the particular attackers, and the victim doesn't pay in a time, the data is gone forever from the particular system. So they are going to provide such kind of a vulnerable kind of a activity with the data. So these are the some malicious code which will be available with the used by the particular cyber attackers or criminal and a person to get access of your system, to get access your particular networks. So in the next lecture we are going to discuss the another topic of that is the vulnerabilities, and many more topics regarding the cyber security. Thank you very much for watching these sessions. I hope ki your concept get clear. In next lecture we are going to discuss another topic. Thank you very much.